Okay, next we have boards and commissions, and then we have a closed session.
Citizens, have you ever given that very kind of your discretionary citizens against crime? What I've got is a group that's doing a holiday memorial service for homicide victims, a remembrance service, and this Thursday, and they're not in the office. And we've got it, so maybe we need to contact citizens against crime and ask them to do that.
Worth it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, can we go through these board vacancies?
On the organization development, we have an audit committee. That's an application for appointment to the audit committee from Brian Jackson.
Okay, Brian Jackson for audit committee. I know they need they're looking to put a lawyer on it. Brian has sent in his application. Any problems with that? Okay.
The next one is RPDC. We have Lynn McAteer. She's for reappointment, and she's going to be the planning commission representative.
Mm-hmm. Everybody okay with Lynn? Okay.
And further, and you'll have her being reappointed on the planning commission, which coincides with this.
Okay. Oh, okay, I gotcha.
For the affordable housing trust fund city council appointment, we have Allison Wadanovich. For the mayor appointment, we don't have any application, we just have names. So we were unable to get an application for those.
Okay. So the only one that's before us is Allison. Wadanovich?
Are you working on different applications for these?
We sent an email to Suzette. She's trying to get those, but we don't have any addresses.
Madam President.
Yes, sir.
I have had through Virginia Supportive Housing in my role at VHDA interaction with Bogdanovich, and she's excellent. Did the first mixed income property in the state that also had homelessness addressed in it. So they were having a mix of homelessness and people with less than 50% area median income. So, she would be an excellent appointee.
Thank you. All right. So I think Allison's good. How about I have petitioned for the ambulance authority. More you do too, Dr. Williams.
Yes. Reappointment.
Mm-hmm.
Reappointment. Yes. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely excellent.
CCJB. We have a reappointment for Judge Jenkins, and also have an appointment for his designee, Michelle Miller.
Everybody okay with that?
Yes.
Okay.
We have an appointment for ASAP. Alexis Fisher-Ritz.
Yes.
Okay. Anybody, everybody's okay with that? Okay.
On the land use, we have Central Virginia Waste Management Authority, appointment of Johnny Allen.
Everybody okay with that? All right.
Building Code Board of Appeals, General Division, all these are reappointment.
Okay.
Thomas Davis, John Rock, Wim Foon, James Snore, and Nelson Williams.
Okay. Everybody all right with those? These guys are hard to get.
Yeah.
Right. Madam President.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir, Mr. Elbert.
Do these individuals have to have no contract work with the city, or how does that work?
Not sure.
They would either have to work in the city or
Yeah.
That's the only part of it.
I'm just wondering if someone is a subcontractor of a, with the contract with the city, does that, I mean, I don't think it would, but I'm just asking a question. Is that a conflict?
It probably would not be. You almost always have to look at specifics of each individual, but given what we're talking about here, probably.
Okay. Just they would have to recuse themselves if something was.
Yeah, unlikely.
Okay. Somebody came before them. Okay. Thank you, Madam President.
Is that, are you looking at Williams?
No, I was looking at Davis.
Okay, I think they all do have things that come before.
Okay, so we're good.
Okay, Planning Commission?
Lynn McAteer, we did hers.
Okay.
For Clean City Commission, we have, these are appointments. Gary Huff, Angela Brown, Catherine Roach, Angie Henning, and Carol Merritt. These are the appointment to the Clean City Commission.
That's coming up?
Yes.
Catherine Roach and
Carol Merritt. And you have a reappointment for Clean City, it's Jan Hodges.
So Mr. Hewlett, can you give that one now? Mr. Hewlett?
No.
No?
He served his term.
Yeah, I was gonna say maybe his term is.
He served his 2 terms. Okay, for Carr, we have a reappointment, Matthew Adams.
Okay.
Is that? Okay.
Urban Design, these are appointments. Andrea Almond. And Jack.
Hartsburg.
Yes.
Okay.
Urban Forestry Commission. Again, this is a reappointment. Ms. Almond, she's gonna be reappointed. And Joel.
Cosey.
Yes.
Education and Health and Human Services. Advisory Board of Recreation and Parks, Andrew Henning.
Okay. Everybody okay with that?
All good.
RBAJ reappointment. Emma Moore.
Squirrels, Emma.
Mm-hmm.
You're good with that?
I'm good. Mr. Connor's good with that.
Okay. All right.
Okay, Community College. Ernesto Sampson.
Ernesto Sampson. That's an appointment for Jay Sarge.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, everybody good with that?
Louis Ginter, Botanical Gardens, reappointment. James Starkey.
I'm good with that.
Finance, we have Economic Development Authority. We have Ms. Reaver for reappointment.
Okay.
Jane Reaver.
All right.
Minority Business Enterprise and Emerging Small Business Advisory Board. We have 2 reappointments. Charles Crenshaw, Tracy Jeter.
All right.
For GovOps, we have City Personnel Board, 2 reappointments. Paul Jackson and Lawanda Shaw Thrower.
Okay. And just for Persinger's camera, these all have gone through committee. So.
These what?
They have all gone through committee.
Right.
Okay. All right. Now, at this time, I believe our next order of business is a closed session.
Yes.
Okay. And I think we need a motion. Does somebody have a motion? Okay.
I move that the Organization Development Standing Committee of the City Council go into closed session is referred to Section 2.2-3711A1 to discuss the assignment, appointment, performance, and salary of certain council liaisons and appointees of the City Council.
Second.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay.